Greetings! Since the holiday season is upon the U.S. and many like myself are preparing the menu for our Christmas dinners, I wanted to talk about hunger and what are some of the things that we hunger for. So we collectively hunger for love. We hunger for connection. We hunger for acceptance, to be seen, to be heard. And we hunger for nourishment and not just food, right? When my African ancestors were enslaved here, we were given food that was often scraps, right? Garbage food. And we basically were expected to prepare this food for our loved ones. So my ancestors would prepare this food for their families. They would put their heart into making it something that is delicious. And so this food became known as soul food, right? But every culture has soul food. Every culture has a version of food that's considered soul food. And why is it soul food? Because it's usually food that's prepared by someone who loves the person that they're preparing it for. It's usually prepared with the intention of the receiver to feel nourished, to feel cared for. So nourishment is just not limited to food, however, right? It extends to the things that also feed our soul. They nourish our soul, right? Things that nourish our soul are things like literature, theater, dance, and art. All of these things, they help our growth and they help our spirits. So I'm talking about how the things that we hunger for are deeper than the body. We hunger from the depths of our souls. And what I want to bring to light today and just give as a reminder is that during this holiday season, let's try to focus on the things that feed our soul, the things that nourish our spirit, so that we don't have a starvation that can consume us because we're not feeding that deeper part of ourselves. So you can ask yourself if your relationships, your job, your hobbies, do these things nourish you? And if not, how are you going to change that, right? Another good thing is to focus on is gratitude. Gratitude extends from Thanksgiving into every day. Gratitude is very nourishing. It helps us to heal. When we appreciate and give thanks for the many blessings that we all have, everyone has something to give thanks to be thankful for, especially during this holiday season, no matter what your circumstances are. So also as a Reiki healer, I definitely want to offer my services because Reiki healing can address some of the feelings of emptiness that can occur when we are lacking in that soul nourishment. And it can also put us in balance so that we can get on the path to nourishing our spirit and our soul the way that we need to for this journey of life. So if you're interested in distance Reiki and you want to set up some healing, please hit me up on my DM and I'll be happy to answer any questions. I'm sending you lots of love during this holiday season. Ashe.